Grand afternoon and grand risings, Libras. Short energy update. I know some of y'all like to see the cards. Cards aren't always necessary. It's about the energies. But we'll get back to the cards a little bit later. Sun, moon, rising, north node, Libra. Wherever it's placed in your chart, you know you are welcome. Right here, you cross watchers, you ops, you're welcome too. Libras, they are so mad at you. God dang, Libras, y'all just the one that just continues to get away. I have never, let me repeat this, let me say it slowly for the ones in the back. I have never seen so many out of place, out of pocket people on their phones. Nobody wants to show their faces. Every time I acknowledge one of these stalkers, these watchers, these spotters, people start pulling their shades down in the car, you know, the sunshade, so I can't see their face. They start reaching around in their car to pull out their sunglasses. A lot of them are wearing baseball caps, men and women. They've sent people every race, creed, background you can imagine. It was so crazy, and I told you these fuckers been drinking, and they've been drinking on the job. Get this. I just happened to stop at McDonald's. Now, I don't eat McDonald's. It wasn't for me, but anywho. I just happened to stop at McDonald's. I get out the car. I see this Caucasian gentleman. And I'm being very gentle with my words. I don't have to be respectful, but that's just my natural nature. I saw this Caucasian gentleman walking not in my direction. Now, as soon as he noticed, because he was on his phone texting, as he was walking, not towards me, but kind of in my direction. Once he noticed that I had walked in McDonald's, his whole direction changed. And the angels already told me, watch him. Of course, I'm always watching. Whether my eyes are closed or open, I'm always watching. So this gentleman proceeded to change his course of direction to come in McDonald's right behind me. And I made sure not to hold the door open. He came in behind me. This gentleman only had his cell phone in his hand. So I go to the counter to get the food. Oh, there go the neighbors with the noise distractions because they're upset, slamming doors and everything. Oh, they're so mad. They're so mad. So this gentleman goes into the seating area and he's standing there for a minute. I'm watching him. Then he comes from on the other side of the seating area because there's like a little partition that separates like the front of the restaurant where you order your food from the seating area. He stepped on the other side of the partition. He now had a McDonald's cup in his hand. There was still ice in the cup. He approached the counter and he asked one of the employees for a refill of Dr. Pepper. When he stepped up to the counter, he stepped in front of me. Of course, I wasn't close to him. But I noticed that he had a bottle of dark liquor in his back left pocket. I told you these fuckers are drinking on the job. I'm not sure what kind of dark liquor it was, but it was dark liquor. So I had a feeling that he dug in the trash that was probably located in the seating area and got that cup out of the garbage. Again, when he walked into the restaurant, he didn't have a McDonald's cup. All that he had in his hand was his phone. He asked three employees for a refill of Dr. Pepper. He kept looking back, looking at me. He was real nervous, half gosh damn drunk. Now, I got my food and walked out of the restaurant. He came out the restaurant right after me, right on that phone. When he was standing at the counter waiting for the second lady who he had asked for a refill from, because it seemed like the first lady paid him no mind. The second lady, she was back there grabbing orders and doing some other shit, so she was taking some time. But I noticed he kept putting his phone to his ear. Now, the third time that he lifted his phone to his ear, the screen was black. So he wasn't talking to anyone. He wasn't on the phone. He wasn't calling anyone. No one was calling him. He was talking to a ghost in the machine. So as I leave the restaurant, this gentleman comes out of McDonald's right behind me. I go to my vehicle. I make sure I'm safe and secure entering my vehicle, as I always am. And this gentleman walks off in a different direction, different than he was kind of originally heading. Fast on his phone, texting, typing, phone to his ear, texting. I'm like, how are you on a phone call and you texting at the same time? He just kept lifting the phone to his ear, texting and typing, lifting. As I'm pulling out of the parking lot, and he's just watching me, and I wanted him to know that I was watching him. I also took pictures of this gentleman. I'm not sure your ops know that you know who they are, and I know, Libras, that I'm not the only one taking copious notes. Since these people want to study them, or study you, rather. Oh, thank you, Spirit. See, these people don't understand that they're also part of an experiment. It's what the head honchos do to those that they initiate. Yeah, these people are initiates. They've been, again, initiated into this group dynamic, this following, to follow you. These people have lost their ever-loving mind. They can't keep a car on you. They're constantly switching vehicles. It's like they literally have a net of people in your city, wherever you may be, Libra, watching you, following you, stalking you, spotting you. Now, I know we live in the modern age. We live in the age of technology, of information and technology. I know people are constantly on their phones. It's not unusual to be out in public and see people face down in their phone. Let me say this again for the ones in the back. I have never seen so many faces glued to their phone screens, whether they are driving, whether they are sitting or standing or still. The spotters, the watchers, the stalkers are being watched as well. I can't say it enough. Your ancestors, your archangels are heavy on the case. Some of you have become welcomed by Orishas. The Orishas are now working with you. Some of you may know this. Some of you have already made contact and have gotten yourselves comfy and cozy with the Orishas on your team. Now, I have spoken it aloud all day because I know these jokers are watching. They're not only watching, they're listening. Listening through my phone, listening through devices in my home, listening through devices in my vehicle. I have explained to them all day that it's not a good idea to continue to follow me. It's not a good idea to involve themselves, to invest themselves. And whatever this group is, the tasks that these energies, these entities within these energies have taken up, is all going to be annihilated. Idaho, California, Utah, Washington, Florida, all of these out-of-state places keep appearing, keep showing up. They keep sending all of these out-of-state contractors after you as if you wouldn't still sense their energy. I guess these head honchos feel like you might be highly attuned to the energy in your city, thereby you might be more easily able to distinguish the ops from regular people in your city. That's just not the case. For you ops out there watching, listening, because I know you are, please do understand that Libra fuels your energy. You're shady. You do shady shit. Your energy is shady. You're dirty. Libra has cleaned up their life. Libra has been working on themselves. Libra has become very intimate with the Most High, their higher self, their spiritual team. And no, not intimate in the sense that you perverts may be thinking about, because you're all perverted, you're all inverted. And that's why you won't achieve or accomplish your goals of hurting, harming, or bringing any sort of demise to my Libras. Y'all chose the wrong one. The Most High did not. You will have these accidents. You will spin out. You will end up in a ditch. You will have your home taken. Your house will catch on fire. You will lose business. Your children, your legacies will be affected. No one will remember your names. And it is because of the task that you have taken up in tracking and tracing, following, stalking, watching, and spotting my Libras. We're watching you. Furthermore, Libra spiritual team is watching you. And even further than that, even higher, it's the highest. The Most High is watching you. You will not escape this karma. The Orishas are coming for you. The ancestors are coming for you. The archangels, the angels, the ascended masters, the spirit guides, the spirit animals, they're all coming for you. You really picked the wrong one. Hey agents, paging Agent Smith, one of your contractors already had an accident today. And I know how you like to work in groups and small clusters. You like to compartmentalize things to keep things separate from others that are committed to this task of taking down my Libra. Just so you know, even though you try to compartmentalize things, even though you try to separate things, word will get out that one of your contractors, one of your agents, was involved in a very serious accident. All that has been done in the dark will be brought to the light. You can't hide this information. Your contractors will find out. And once they find out that that one contractor was injured in a vehicle accident, they will turn around, they will pull off, they will back out. You may have controlled them through mind manipulation, through spell work, through injections, through nanotechnology. You're very inhumane. You've lost all your humanity. You've given it up, and God's had enough. Libras, ma'am, sir, lady, man, high vibe tribe, I'm talking to you. Know that you are very well safeguarded, protected, assisted, and guided in all passages of moments. There is nothing for you to worry about. If you are feeling any type of concerns, give these concerns to your angels. Give these concerns to the Most High. The Most High would never leave you. All of these characters are being baited, and they will be trapped. They're already trapped. They just don't realize they're in a cage. Libras, I love you. Please do continue to utilize your swift intuition and discernment to continue making the very best decisions for your highest good. Any and all pertinent information to this reading can and will be listed right down below. Libras, thank you so much for your presence, your energy, your vibes, your likes, your shares, your subscribes, your comments, your contributions. We are getting stronger by the day, by the minute, in fact. You get updates, Libra, minute by minute, second by second, moment by moment. Remember, this is the age of information. And just as speedy as information comes to us via technology, it's coming even faster spiritually. These people better hold on to their hats, their asses, and whatever else they can grab. Because Libras, we will hold it down. It's our time. It's the uprising of the new soldiers. They can call us mutants if they want to. It's just out of jealousy and envy that they have not chosen to utilize their gifts, their skills, their natural abilities that God gave them for good. And so they shall be wiped out. Have no fears, Libras. I'm wishing you all a happy, healthy, productive, and peaceful day. I love you. United we stand, together we rise. Holla at your girl. Peace.